a home remedy worsens symptoms, stop using it. Contact a doctor or your esthetician. So if it was a doctor that gave you something, your derm or someone, you stop using, you call and he says, hey, this thing is making me do this or that. But you stop it before you call right away. Anything that's not working with you, immediately stop that. And if it was I or another esthetician, again, you stop and you want to talk to them because there might be a mediating process that you might want to do, not just stopping it, but there might be something you need to get in there to change what's going on. Maybe some hyperpigmentation or some inflammation that might start. Get it, Amy. Okay, so now we're going to talk about oily skin from the kitchen. And most of us have oily skin. We call it combination skin, but we'll find that some of us say, well, I'm oily up here in the forehead. I'm always oily up there. And oily around here on the nose, but I'm dry everywhere else. Some of us can say that, right? Mm-hmm. Some of us can say, you know what, I'm completely dry. So for the ones that are in the class that knows that you're always completely dry, don't feel bad. It's knowledge. Knowledge is gold, and if you can't use it, somebody else will. So you'll walk away with a wealth of knowledge. You can say, hey, okay, so you have oily skin. Maybe these are some of the things you want to do. So if you feel like you're suffering from dry skin, don't think that this does not apply to you. It might apply to someone else that you can. Okay. All right, so let's look at some ingredients. We have honey, oatmeal, yogurt, mashed fruits like banana, apples, or papaya. I love these because there's so much that can come out of it. And the egg white. Oops, the eggs.